Thank you. Incredible! Can you really see me? I'm so glad. Perhaps you'll be able to help me. After my wife Sylvia died, I tried to recreate her face in marble, but I failed. I couldn't make the cold, dead stone look like she did. The face looked like any other bust. After several sleepless weeks, I went mad. I dug up my wife's grave, took her skull, and used it as a model for the head of my statue. Since then, I've been unable to find peace or Sylvia's soul. Please return Sylvia's skull to its grave.
You're really smart. I didn't expect you to be so brave and quick-witted. Everything has transpired as Gabriel said it would. Thank you for your help, young lady. My headache is gone and I feel much better.
Kate. I'm so pleased to meet you. I've heard a lot about your exploits in the House of a Thousand Doors. I hope you will help me too. The workshop here where I restore paintings is behind this door. I was removing a layer of paint from an old canvas when flames burst out of the painting and consumed my workshop. Now I can't go in there. Maybe you could help me to find out what happened. In the meantime, I'll go find my bird.
Thank you. poor daddy. He wanted to provide for us, so he agreed to do some work for a scary man. As my daddy started drawing the canvas, flames burst out from the painting. The fire burned up everything. My daddy's workshop, my toys, everything. There was no way out. I was scared, and I started crying. At that moment, my face appeared on the canvas. Please help me, ma'am. I don't like being in this blackened house, and I want my daddy. Thank you, ma'am. That scary painting won't hurt me or the other kids anymore. A powerful wizard created it in order to collect sad feelings and tears, all of which made the painting even more powerful. There's only one way to defeat the dark magic. Throw the painting and its frame into the well of the eternal flame.